Hello to everyone. In this lecture, this is second lecture of inverse trigonometric function. So in inverse trigonometry, in this second lecture, we will discuss about the sum and difference of the different angles on inverse trigonometry, as it is analogous to that the compound and allied angles what we discussed already in trigonometry chapter. So that is the same concept. We will go for inverse trigonometry. So let's see how to tackle this. So first of all, we will go for tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, then we go for sine inverse and cos inverse and else also besides. So we have to check the conditions are here, the more about the condition to see how these results comes, and these results should also be by heart. As far for IIT JEE point of view, if you see, then the result that is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y and tan inverse x minus tan inverse y, these two results are very important rather than others. So let's see about this first results, that is the section 2 part of this first one, that is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. So tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, if you see here, the this is actually there are the two angles, you know, let this be say A, and this what do we call this, you can say this is B. So let this two angles A and B, as it is analogous to this one and formula that what we call tan of A plus B. If you see here, then we know well that tan of that, let me write tan A plus B. What is called tan A plus B? That is tan A plus tan B, you all know well. Tan A plus tan B upon 1 minus tan A into tan B. Analogous to this formula, we will go and check for tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, how these conditions will be defined. So for this result, what we see here, later on we will assume for tan A that is x, and for tan B that we can assume as y. So that it will become that is tan A for x and tan B for y. So this should be the under the condition that A and B also, we have to make up the condition that is lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Why so? Because this is the, this will be further, if you see the range of tan inverse x is minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. Within this, the function is increasing. And if you see the graph of tan A and tan x also, then between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, let me write here minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2, right? So tan x graph is like this way, this is increasing. So only to fulfill the condition of this bijective, we will invert this with the line respect to y equal to x. And as you know, the graph of tan inverse x also, that is the same as here, that is the graph of tan inverse x is also like this way, minus, and it is between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. That is the inversion of inverse function of tan x. That is, this is x axis and this what you call y axis. So this graph is also lies between minus pi by 2 and plus pi by 2. These dotted lines are known as asymptotes, you know. So within this line only we have to analyze. So angle A and B you have to consider, and then within open interval minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So let's see. So if you say here tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, that is if we assume tan inverse x and tan inverse y as A and B, that what we call, if you say this is A, this will be B later on, then we will go for to solve this tan inverse x plus y as tan inverse of x plus y upon 1 minus xy under the condition when xy is less than 1. When x is positive and y is positive and xy is greater than 1, then the condition will be pi plus tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy, right? And when x is negative and y is negative and still xy is greater than 1. In this two cases, xy is greater than 1, and here this is the case when xy is less than 1. So if xy is greater than 1, minus pi plus tan inverse of x plus y upon 1 minus xy. So now let's prove this all. So to see this, what we have to go, we have to make this cases. So that is the case one. And let me once again note down this one, step by step to get this idea. Then here you have to assume as let. Let me write. Let tan inverse x equal to capital A. Okay. And that we say tan inverse y is equal to b. And then we have to say then let x equal to what we call tan A and y equal to tan B. Y equal to tan B, right? And A and B belongs to and A comma B belongs to minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2 open interval, right? So you all know well, and in the next step you have to write down the tan A plus tan B. Note down this much only. First of all, you all please go through writing work along with me, then you will understand properly this one. So let's say here that is then after what we call tan A, tan of that what we say plus B, as you all know well the formula, as I have written this also, tan A plus tan B upon 1 minus tan A into tan B. And tan A, what we has assumed, that was x plus y upon 1 minus xy. Here now the following cases arises. Now the following cases arises. Let me write here. Arises. Okay. So here you see that so let case 1 assume as case 1. In case 1, what we call that is when x is positive, when x is positive, y is also positive, you see, y is positive and xy is less than 1. This was the case 1, you know. So in this case, as you know, in this case, x is positive, y is positive and xy is less than 1. This implies that what we call here x plus y upon 1 minus xy, what it will be, you know, if x is positive and y is positive, so in numerator part is positive and xy is less than 1, so if you see denominator 1 minus xy is, so you see 1 minus xy is also positive, so numerator is positive, denominator is positive, so the result will be also positive, correct? So you make it positive and this will become, later on you say this will become tan of A plus B. So let me write here tan of A plus B. Okay, this is also positive. How tan of A plus B? This will become tan of A plus B, you know. This result will become tan of A plus B. This entire thing is tan of A plus B, you know. So as tan of A plus B is positive. So if you see here, A plus B lies in first quadrant or in third quadrant. So that what we call here, that A plus B, this implies, let me write over here. So this implies A plus B lies in first quadrant or in third quadrant. First quadrant or in third quadrant. Okay. Why so? because in first and third quadrant only tan is positive. So therefore a plus b lies between 0 to pi by 2. You know, this is a plus b lies between 0 to pi by 2. Now since that what we call here x is positive, this implies a is greater than 0 and less than pi by 2, whereas y is positive, this implies b is also greater than 0 and less than, you know, pi by 2, and this entire thing implies, this implies, I will write over here, I will write this thing here. So this implies, this implies, let me write down here, a plus b, this result, a plus b lies between 0 to pi. Are you getting? If you add these two terms, this a and this b, if you add this, then what happened? In left side, the inequality will be same. A plus b will become, if you add this a plus b, then it is 0, and pi by 2 plus pi by 2 sum is pi. Correct? So a plus b lies between 0 to pi. And from 1, what we, equation 1, what we have discussed, if you see backward, tan of a plus b was x plus y upon 1 minus x y. So that what we call here, tan of a plus b will become, so what we see here, tan of a plus b will become, tan of a plus b will become as x plus y upon 1 minus xy. Okay, so that what we say here, a plus b can be written now as tan inverse, right, x plus y upon 1 minus xy. Can we write like this, sir? Now instead of a and b, what we have assumed, that was tan inverse, a was tan inverse x and b was tan inverse y, because x we have assumed tan a and y for tan b. So safely we can write over here, that is tan inverse x. So let me note down, tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse and this is the case 1. So if you see this case 1, when a plus b lies between 0 to pi, a plus b lies between 0 to pi, this is means x is positive and y is positive, and xy become less than 1. So when xy is less than 1, so that we say, if xy is less than 1, so that we say x plus y, this part will become, if xy is less than 1, this part will become positive, and hence this part will become positive. We have already shown this. Let me note down here, this is positive part. So that's why here this is the justify for first case. So if you see over here, this is the first case we have already discussed. So now we'll go for another cases also. So let's see for another cases. In another case, the second case, when x is positive and y is positive, but xy is greater than 1, then what we call here, we say pi plus tan inverse x plus y upon that we say 1 minus xy. So okay, so let's see about this one. Second case, we will now go for second part, this part, pi plus tan inverse x. Let's see how. So let's go and check once again like this. Okay, so let me, so in the second case, when here, let me note down, second case, case 2. So here, as you know, x is positive, y is also positive, and xy greater than 1. If so, in this case, we have x is positive, y is positive, xy greater than positive. So what we say about this one? Let's see, x plus y upon 1 minus xy, that it will, you see, in numerator what the happen, x is positive, y is positive, so numerator is positive, okay, but xy is greater than 1. If xy is greater than 1, you transpose this xy, so 1 minus xy will become less than 0, so denominator portion is negative and numerator is positive, so finally the result will be negative. Fine. So as it is negative, we say tan of a plus b is what, negative or positive? Of course it is negative. So from 1 we say, as instead of this we can write tan of a plus b was x plus y upon 1 minus xy. So what this infers? This infer that a plus b, let me tell it. So what we recall over here, that is a plus b, okay, lies in which quadrant? You can guess. Can you guess over here? Where is tan is negative? That is in second and fourth quadrant. So it lies in second and fourth quadrant. So as it is lies in second and fourth quadrant, so we'll first assume as a plus b lies in second quadrant. So if a plus b is lies in second quadrant, so let's say a plus b lies in second quadrant. Let's say second quadrant. So the reason that is x is positive, y is positive, and this implies that is a comma b belongs to 0 to pi by 2, right? Then therefore this implies that we say a plus b will become, when you add this, then this belongs to that what we call here 0 to pi. Pi by 2 and pi by 2, that is pi. That is same what we discussed earlier. So that we say a plus b, let me check on a plus b. So you say a plus b, okay, so less than pi, and here that we say greater than pi by 2, okay. So a plus b, as it lies between 0 to pi, so we have to go for in second quadrant, as a plus b lies between pi by 2 to pi. So what we recall over here, if you see, then we can write a plus b minus pi is less than 0, means in other words, you can say you can subtract pi from both sides. So pi by 2 minus pi, we can write like this, right? A plus b is greater than this one. Okay, we note down properly. So what we see here, a plus b is greater than this. So a plus b, finally we get a plus b. Okay, a plus b under bracket, right, minus pi is less than 0, and here greater than pi by 2 minus pi, that is minus pi by 2. Okay, minus pi by 2. So finally what we conclude over here, that is a plus b minus pi lies between minus pi by 2 to 0, and this shows, this we can say that tan of a plus b is equal to tan of, let me note down, tan of a plus b, that what was that? That was x plus y upon 1 minus xy, right? So tan of a plus b we can write like this way, because we have to manage this a plus b minus pi. So if you manage like this way, so that will be minus tan 180 minus theta will be minus tan theta. So minus we will adjust this, एंड वन कैन राइट लाइक दिस से पाई माइनस ऑफ ए प्लस बी अंडर ब्रैकेट एंड दिस इज अनदर ब्रैकेट इज इक्वल टू दैट इज सेम व्हाट वाज एक्स प्लस वाई ओके एंड वन माइनस एक्स वाई ओके फाइन सो दिस माइनस कैन बी एडजस्ट लेटर ऑन लाइक दिस वे वन कैन राइट टेन ऑफ दैट इज ए प्लस बी एंड माइनस पाई क्लियर एंड देन वी से दैट इज सेम एज एक्स प्लस वाई एंड वन माइनस एक्स वाई दैट इज वन माइनस एक्स वाई एंड हेंस वी से ए प्लस बी माइनस पाई वी कैन राइट लाइक दिस वे ए प्लस बी माइनस पाई इज इक्वल टू नाउ वी कैन राइट टैन इनवर्स एक्स प्लस वाई अपॉन दैट इज वन माइनस एक्स एक्स इंटू वाई वन माइनस एक्स इंटू वाई ओके लेट मी नोट डाउन इन ब्रैकेट दिस इन ब्रैकेट ओके फाइन सो व्हाट वी रिकॉल ओवर हियर दैट इज फाइन नाउ यू कैन ट्रांसपोज दिस पाई इन राइट वर्ड्स सो वी कैन से हियर लाइक ए प्लस बी ओके सो लेट मी राइट ऑन दिस व्हाट वाज द ए प्लस बी एंड पाई यू हैव टू ट्रांसपोज ना ओके सो दैट इज ए So that was so what was there? That is a plus b is equal to pi plus tan inverse that was x plus y upon 1 minus xy fine so instead of a and b we can write safely tan inverse x plus that is tan inverse y is equal to pi plus tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy okay this is the result over here so finally we get this condition tan inverse x plus tan inverse y that was pi plus tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy and this was the under the condition that condition was x is positive y was positive and xy we have to consider greater than 1 right okay so one more case will be there third case that we have to go now like this one with the red color we will notify that is the case here the despite of second case this one is minus pi plus tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy If x is negative and y is negative, despite of second, that is x is negative and y is negative. Although xy is greater than 1 is considered here. That the two different parts, xy is, one of them is less than 1 and here two of them is xy is greater than 1. So, but here this will be xy, x is negative and y is negative. And we have to consider this as, that is xy is greater than 1. So let's see over here. Although if you consider x positive, y positive, x negative, y negative, then a lot of cases will be there. So here particularly if you see that there will be five cases arises. So but we have minimized this conditions only in three cases as we are ignoring this one negative portion, negative region. So because tan inverse minus x you can write finally minus tan inverse x. So that doesn't matter, you can adjust this. So only if you remember this three cases here, then it is sufficient to handle every variety of problems. So just go, let's go. This one, third cases, third case. So what is third case? In third case, that is, let's see, here is x is negative, y is also negative here, right? And then xy is greater than 1. So we have to go for this one. And the result will be minus pi plus tan inverse x plus y. Okay, so let's see about this, how to tackle this. And what we say here, so let's say same thing, let me write down first here, that is case 3. In the case 3, you know that we have to assume x is negative, y is negative, right, and xy is greater than 1. Okay, so here what you call, that is x plus y upon 1 minus xy. What about this one? Positive or negative? Think about first. X is negative, y is negative, numerator is negative, right? Xy is greater than 1. So 1 minus xy is, this one is also negative. So as you know, numerator and denominator are both negative. So finally, the result will become positive. Fine. So that what we go for the case, that is tan of a plus b is positive. So what we say here, tan of a plus b, that is positive. Fine. So from 1 we can say tan a plus b positive, right? So tan a plus b lies in which quadrant? Tan a plus b lies in, let me write here, tan of a plus b lies in, that is, you say where it is positive? So first and third quadrant, right? First and third quadrant. Tan a plus b lies in first and third quadrant. So let's say a plus b lies in third quadrant, right? So let's say a plus b lies in third quadrant. Okay, so for third quadrant, what we recall over here, a plus b is less than minus pi by 2 and greater than minus pi. So what we call over here, if you add pi in each and every side, then what the result will be? This result will become, that is pi minus pi by 2, right side, and the left side will become pi minus pi, greater than pi minus pi, the result will become 0, and hence we say pi plus a plus b, and that is pi minus pi by 2, that is, you know, that is pi by 2. So what we call over here, that is tan a plus b, tan of what we say here, a plus b, okay, and tan of a plus b is equal to x plus y upon 1 minus xy, and hence we say tan of pi plus a plus b. How comes? If you add this pi, means angle is going where? It is in third quadrant, and in third quadrant, you know, tan is positive. So tan of pi plus a plus b is equal to x plus y upon 1 minus xy, and tan pi plus a plus b will become, then that is positive, right? So we can say pi plus a plus b is here, that what we call tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. Okay, so finally, if you transpose this pi, then it will become a plus b is equal to, that is minus pi plus tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus, you know, xy, 1 minus. Once more, the same line as here, let's see. So a plus b will become, so it will recap also, a plus b is here minus pi plus tan inverse minus pi plus tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. Okay, so for a plus b, what we call, that is tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to minus pi plus tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. Okay, so this will be the result, and these are the conditions under, you know, that is, hope so, hopefully you are getting x is negative, let me write down once more, y is negative and xy was greater than 1. Okay, fine. So let's see, this is the entire condition of tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, that is tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy, that was the case 1. And here, if xy is greater than 1, then we have to, we won't write directly tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. We have to add this pi either with positive pi or negative pi. So, to just for learning basis, just for memorizing, you can think about this. If x and y, this 2x and y, I will give the clue over here, that if x is positive, y is positive, then you have to add positive. If x is negative and y is negative, then you have to add this negative pi. That is the point over here. In this way you can memorize. But if xy is less than 1, no need to add pi over here. Simply tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. Similarly, go for second formula. Tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. That is the difference between two angles. There are still three conditions. Xy is greater than minus 1. And here two more conditions will be there for xy less than minus 1, respectively for first condition, that is x positive, y negative, and x negative and y positive. So let's go and check how to prove this. So to prove this, the difference of angle in tan inverse, we have to assume, let tan inverse x equal to a and tan inverse y equal to b. So let's say, that we say here, say tan inverse to b. A and b both belongs to minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. A, you know, comma b belongs to minus pi by 2 comma pi by 2, open interval we have to say. And you know, that is, we say x equal to tan a, and also y equal to, what do we call, y equal to, that is tan b, one can say. Now, as you know, the formula of tan of a minus b, that what we call here, tan a minus tan b, you all know well, tan a minus tan b upon 1 plus tan a into tan b. That simply we can say x minus y upon 1 plus xy. This is actually tan of a minus b. And let's say, let this say, this is identity number 1. This identity will play the different role here. So case 1. Now let's see here, case 1. Go for case 1. What is case 1? In case 1, xy we have to consider greater than minus 1, as you have shown. So if x is positive, y is also positive, then you know what you have to write? A lies between, means x is positive, y is positive. So tan inverse, when it is positive, so when a is lies between 0 to pi, a and b, both of them lies between 0 to pi by 2, pi by 2 you can write over here, means open interval, that is. So we recall tan of a minus b is equal to x minus y upon 1 plus xy, and hence we say that is a minus b, that we call tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy, this is minus. So what we call here, for a we can write tan inverse x, and for b we can say tan inverse y, and hence we can say tan inverse, right? And tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy. You can say this is thing here. At what we call recall here, that is xy. Let me write, and here that is the same what we call tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy. So finally we can get tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse that we call x minus y upon 1 plus xy for all x and y with xy is greater than minus 1. Now this is a formula, you know, first part, and here similarly you can go for second part as xy is greater than minus 1. That was, we have already proved tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus and then y negatives, and here we have to consider xy less than minus 1. So if x is positive and y is negative, this implies a belongs to 0 to pi by 2 and b belongs to, you know, that is minus pi by 2 to 0, right? But we have to find a minus b. So a minus b belongs to where? A minus b, you know, it belongs to if you add this, because minus b will belongs later on 0 to pi by 2, and when you add, then you find a minus b belongs to 0 to, that is pi, because pi by 2 plus pi by 2, that is pi, 0 to pi open interval. If you are not getting, I can show this also. Better you can do yourself. You write b in equality form as b is less than 0 and greater than minus pi by 2, and then multiply with negative sign both side. So minus b lies between 0 to pi by 2, and then add this a and minus b inequality. As a lies between 0 to pi by 2, minus b lies between 0 to pi by 2. Now when a minus b lies between 0 to pi, again x is positive, correct, and y, that what we call negative, and you know xy is less than minus 1. So what we recall over here, you can say that x is positive, and for as y was negative, so we can write supposing one left side, so 1 plus xy is, it will be less than 0, correct? So finally what we recall, x minus y upon 1 plus xy. Now check the condition of this, that will be also negative. Hence we can say tan of a minus b is less than 0. As tan of a minus b less than 0, so a minus b belongs to, from where to where? That is pi by 2 to pi, because you know that is, it is negative where it is in second quadrant. So a minus b will become spanned over pi by 2 to a pi. Yes, a minus b will become pi by 2 to pi open interval. You can write over here open interval. Fine. So finally what we call here, a minus b is less than pi and greater than pi by 2. Okay, so some student can recall once again to manipulate it, a minus b, and you can put it in bracket, and now pi subtract, so this will become 0, this will become 0, and here greater than, that is minus pi by 2, you can say. And therefore, one can write over here, tan of a minus b is tan of a minus b, right? Tan of a minus b is equal to as x minus y upon 1 plus xy, you know. And hence we can say, tan of pi minus of a minus b, because tan minus theta minus tan theta, so that we say minus tan of pi minus a minus b, and that will be x minus y upon 1 plus xy, so it will be negative. And if you insert this negative sign here, let me put one more bracket over here, so if you insert this negative sign inside, so that will be tan of, some student can write a minus b minus pi, okay, so a minus b minus pi is equal to, that is x minus y upon 1 plus xy, and hence we can say a minus b minus pi, okay, is equal to tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy. So finally what we recall over here, that is a minus b as here, that is this a minus b, a minus b is equal to transposing this pi over here, so that will become pi plus tan inverse, that is the result, x minus y upon 1 plus xy, okay, 1 plus xy, you can xy, okay. So finally what we say here, that is a minus b, let me note down once again here, that is pi plus tan inverse, that is x minus y upon 1 plus xy, and here later on use, instead of a b, you can say that will be tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is equal to pi plus tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy. Once again, let me recall under which condition was there. This was the condition when x is positive, y was negative, and here xy is less than minus 1. Let's see, this is the condition. And this we have already shown. Now this condition is left, you can go ahead in the similar way either, or you can show this, you just pause the video and try once again. Here what we say, x is negative, y is positive, and xy, that is less than minus 1, okay, if xy is less than minus 1, you know, then before this you have to go for x minus y is less than 0, you know, because minus y will also negative, and when you add this x and minus y, then it is less than 0, and hence we say that is 1 plus xy, 1 plus xy will become less than 0, transposing this one left side. So what we is negative, so finally that will become positive, so we say tan of a minus b, that is positive, okay, fine, this is positive. So we can say a minus b lies in first quadrant or third quadrant, right? So that we say a minus b, this one lies in either first quadrant or third quadrant, right? So what we recall over here, that is a minus b if lies in first and third quadrant, how this comes as a is, you can see this here, a is lies between minus pi by 2 to 0 and b lies between 0 to pi by 2. So a minus b lies between minus pi to 0 as x negative and y was positive. So finally we conclude that a minus b lies between minus pi to minus pi by 2 as if we go for third quadrant. So what we recall, let me note on here, that is a minus b is greater than that. It means that we say a minus b is less than that what we call here minus pi by 2. Okay, to go for third quadrant, a minus b is greater than minus pi, right, this angle. And hence we say pi plus, if you add this, pi plus a minus b is less than, if you add pi and within pi minus 2, minus pi by 2, so that will become pi by 2 here. And here if you add this, then it will become 0. So tan of a minus b, you know, as you know, tan of a minus b, as we know well, that x minus y upon 1 plus xy. So tan of a minus b can be written by this, some student can write over here as tan pi plus a minus b. Okay, so that it will become, that is the same here what we say, x my minus 1 plus x minus y upon 1 plus xy. Okay, fine. So tan 180 plus theta, you know, that is tan theta. And hence we say that is means pi plus a minus b, pi plus a minus b is equal to tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy, you know. And hence we say a minus b is equal to pi, if you transpose pi, that is minus pi plus tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy. Okay, and hence we can say a, substituting this a, tan inverse x minus tan inverse y is equal to minus pi plus tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy, right? That is the result. And hence we can say this is the final result, like this. This one, we showed this one. Okay. So in general, if we say x1, x2, x3, and so on, xn belongs to R, then, you know, tan inverse x1, let me write here, tan inverse x1 plus tan inverse x2 plus tan inverse x3 plus so on plus tan inverse xn, if we note down these all, then we say tan inverse, that is s1 minus s2 plus here in this odd terms, s1 minus s3, you know, let me clear about this. S1 minus, that is S3, and here S5, and then S7 will be there, negative sign, so that we say up to so on, dot dot dot, and hence we can recall as 1 minus S2. Okay, this is this is S2, 1 minus S2 plus S4 minus plus S4 minus S6 and so on, that we say negative sign. Here we have to put negative S6, okay, and plus so on, dot dot dot. This is the final result of general idea. And what is SK? Where, let me note down over here how to manage this SK, where SK, K is the suffix, means 1, 2, 3, denotes the sum of the product of denotes the sum of product of that one x1 x2 x3 so on xn x1 here space is not there x1 x2 product of the same that is product of the same line that we say this entire product of x1 x2 x3 so on xn okay these all taken k at a time we can write over here taken k at a time what it means s1 is x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus xn and x3 means you have to taken 3 at a time s5 means taken 5 at a time s2 means taken 2 at a time means all possible combination of x1 with each and every rest as like s2 you write x1 x2 x1 x3 x1 x4 then after x2 x3 and so on like this these are each for every possibility so this is a very general result and it is very helpful regarding for JE problems and here this is a very rich area from where you will find some problems in JE mains and advanced both so let's go through some different problems so let's we take example tan inverse 2 by 11 plus tan inverse 7 by 24 equal to you have to show that tan inverse 1 by 2 so 2 by 11 and 7 by 24 you have to see in which category it follows right so that is tan inverse 2 by 11 and 7 by 4 if you see that is xy is this one is less than minus 1 here you see xy is less than 1 as xy is less than 1 then simply you can add this as x plus y upon 1 minus xy no issue here it is a simple case and hence we can say solving 2 by 11 plus 7 by 24 because when you multiply then you will get a fraction and hence we can say tan inverse 1 by 2 will be there then pause it and solve so no need to so go ahead now check here under this condition what we will do that here once again that is tan inverse x plus tan inverse 2x upon 1 minus x square under the condition mod x is less than 1 here x belongs to all real number and mod x is greater less than 1 by root 3 we have to show this so you consider LHS portion here LHS portion is there LHS portion right so what we see here tan inverse x and tan inverse 2x upon 1 minus x square that later on you can say tan inverse this is 2 tan inverse x also and this will become 3 tan inverse x and 3 tan inverse x formula is over here directly you can show this all and but we will do the using tan inverse x plus tan inverse y so tan inverse x plus tan inverse y applying the formula as you know when we consider here this is considering xy less than 1 and here what we say mod x is less than 1 and x belongs to R so here what we recall that xy is less than 1 so x plus 2x upon 1 minus x square and using this formula 1 minus xy finally we get this result under the condition mod x is less than 1 by root 3 so let's do some problem on this basis so question number 1 you can say here I will write the questions also and you do yourself question number 1 is here you know that is tan inverse 1 by 7 you know down 1 by 7 let me note down once again yes question number 1 tan inverse 1 by 7 plus go ahead tan inverse 1 by 13 then after equal to solve this in terms of single angle so when you combine this angle then you have to see 1 by 77 and 1 by 13 whether the product is less than 1 or not so you can see here yes so xy is less than 1 as xy is less than 1. So simply you just copy out LHS portion, and here tan inverse 1 by 7 and plus tan inverse 1 by 13, you simply add this, both the angles, right? So simply you can use this formula, tan inverse 1 by 7, right, plus 1 by 13 upon 1 minus 1 by 7 into 1 by 13, you know, right? While solving this, if you see, then let's solve, that is 7, 13, plus 7, 20, 20, and 91 minus 1, 90. So that is tan inverse, you know, 7, 13, that is 20 upon, you know, 91. And here in denominator also, 7, 13 is 91 minus 1, 90 upon 91. 90 upon 91, denominator from 91, that is related. So tan inverse 20 by 91, that what we call tan inverse 2 by 9. So final answer will be, that is tan inverse 2 by 9 is your answer. So simply that doesn't matter, here xy was less than 1. So we got had to write like this way. Let's take another problem. Problem number 2, that we say, let me note down here, tan inverse 2 plus tan inverse 3. Tan inverse, yes, 2 plus tan inverse 3. What is the result? So let's try yourself. But here, what we say, here the situation is 2 and 3, as xy is greater than 1. This is the condition when xy is greater than 1. As 2 into 3, that is equal to 6, which is greater than 1. Hence, we can say 6y, 6 which is greater than 1. So, what we recall over here, we have to apply this formula tan inverse x plus tan inverse y under the condition when xy is greater than 1. So, here that what we recall that you have to use pi plus tan inverse x. So, the final answer you have to write pi plus tan inverse x minus y, x plus y upon 1 minus xy. So, finally, we say pi plus tan inverse, that is 2 plus 3 upon 1 minus 2 into 3. And that what we call here, pi plus tan inverse 2 plus 3, that is 5, and 1 minus 6, that is minus 5. Finally, we get minus 1. And tan inverse minus 1, you know, all know well, that pi minus pi by 4. Hence, we can say 3 pi by 4. Similarly, you can go ahead this one. Suppose one question was asked in JE. Let me note down here. Third problem. That is the same thing of the second. Although question was tan inverse 1 plus tan inverse 2 plus tan inverse 3. So as you have seen over here that the result of tan inverse 2 plus 3, that was 3 pi by 4. And here if you see, the result of tan inverse 1, that is undoubtedly it is pi by 4. Everyone know well, no need to tell about this. Tan inverse 1 is pi by 4. So pi by 4 plus 3 pi by 4, what you will add here, you can add and see that the final result is, that is 4 pi by 4, and hence the answer is pi by pi, means that is pi. Okay, so the answer will be pi. Final answer is pi. That is the answer. 4 and 4 are related. And hence we can say this one. Let's do some more question of this tan inverse x and tan inverse y. That what we call here. So let me take some one more problem to solve this, as tan inverse. I want to take some three angles. Tan inverse 1 by 5 plus tan inverse 1 by I can take one more angle to just make a complete understanding. Tan inverse, that we say 1 by 8 is equal to, you have to put the option, fill in the blanks is there. So tan inverse 1 by 5 plus tan inverse 1 by 7 plus tan inverse 1 by 3 plus tan inverse 1 by 8, you have to find how to solve this. You know, tan inverse 1 by 5 plus tan inverse 1 by 7,
you can although here four results are there, so better just go in the brackets, couple up there, and hence we see that, let me raise this and check for both the pairs individually. Also less than 1. So simply tan inverse x plus y, you can use the formula. No need to worry over here. So 1 by 5 plus 1 by 7. And what about this one? Denominator 1 minus 1 by 5 into 1 by 7. Right? Plus once again here, 1 for 1 by 3 and 1 by 8. So 1 by 3 plus 1 by 8. Right? 1 by 8. And here 1 minus 1 by 3 into 1 by 8. And finally, this is the answer. Okay. So what we recall over here? Tan inverse, that is 6 by 17, you know, 6 by 17 it will become, and plus if you solve this 3 at 24, 24 minus 1, 23, 23. So finally, what we see here, 11 by 24, 8 plus 3, 11. 11 by 20, that is 24 minus 1, no? Yes, 23. So 11 by 23. Okay, so solving this now, once again, if you see 6 by 17 and 11 by 23, then the product is also now less than 1. So simply you have to use tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, that is equal to, let me note down here, x plus y upon 1 minus y, nothing else, 6 by 17 and plus 11 by 23 upon 1 minus 6 by 17 and 11 by 23. Okay, so finally what we say here, tan inverse on adding this 325 upon, that is upon also 325, if you see and solve it, that is finally the answer is tan inverse, that is 1, tan inverse 1, and hence we can say the answer is pi by 4, right? Final answer is pi by 4. Okay, so simply you can go ahead for solving this all. So I am interested to take one more problem over here. If you see, you can go ahead for one more problem. Let's see. Now let's take one more problem. It's a good problem based on tan inverse x minus tan inverse y. That is tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy. Here also you have to consider the conditions. So one question is there. Question, let me note down the question first. That is sigma of m equal to 1 to infinity, you have to find, that is tan inverse, hold on, 2m, okay, in numerator, and in denominator, you know, that is m to the power 4 plus m square and plus 2 is there. Okay, so how to tackle this? Let's see. So what we see here, for solution, how to tackle this, you can also try yourself. So it's in such situation, to maintain tan inverse x minus tan inverse y, here the pattern is the final result. When you club this, then you will find tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy. So in denominator, 1 is required. So you have to search out for 1. So as you know, for solution, let me go for solution, is equal to sigma of m equal to 1 to infinity. I will write all those same thing here. Tan inverse 2m upon, that is m to the power 4 plus m square and plus 2. First of all, in the denominator, what is 2 over here? For 2, you can split that as 1 and manipulate this result. So for here, that what we see, 2, you can say 1 plus 1. Later on, we will go for, and you adjust this one in these terms, and this is a way to solve. And here means in denominator, you have to split this at 1 plus xy type structure, such that this product means product of xy, this will become later on for x minus y, so that it will take the pattern of x minus y upon x 1 plus xy. This is our strategy to handle this problem. So now let's start for the solution of this problem. How to tackle this? So let's see. We can write sigma of m equal to 1 to infinity, okay, tan inverse. Although in numerator, what was there? In numerator, if you see, first of all, you have to bother for denominator. For denominator, 1 is required. So I have used 1. And 1 for the using with rest 2 terms. So rest 2 terms can be managed as m square plus 1 whole square. It's okay. And that is minus m square. So here, 2 different advantages you can opt over here. As you know, that is m square plus 1 whole square. That is m to the power 4 plus 1 plus 2m square. And 2m square minus m square, that will be m square. Hence, we can say that is the difference will become, that is the same what the denominator is there. And 1 already used. And one more benefit here, you can use this square difference formula later on. And when you will subtract this 2 terms, as a plus b, a minus b, formula when you will use, then you will get, that is 2m, because m square and 1 term will retaliate from both the brackets. Let's see. So in the first bracket, what you will write? M square plus m plus 1, right? And minus of that, we say m square minus m minus 1. In such problems, you have to be very conscious about that denominator manage as 1 plus xy, and the product of this term is split in subtraction of as x minus y in numerator. Just only this much you have to do, and in this way you can crack the problem. So sigma of m equal to 1 to infinity, and here it will become tan inverse. And finally, what we say here, let me note down, m square plus m plus 1 minus m square minus m minus 1, right? And here that we say 1 plus, you can make this one square difference formula, m square, that is plus 1 plus m, okay? And here m square plus 1 minus m. And the difference of this 2 term only, you find this is in denominator. Hence, we can say that is sigma of m equal to 1 to infinity, that is tan inverse, that is m square, plus m plus 1, and here x minus tan inverse y, what I am writing over here, tan inverse m square minus m minus 1, right? So finally, this is your result. And hence, when you put from m equal to 1 to 1 to infinity, as 1 to infinity, if you put different results, then you will find the result goes like this way. That is, means when you put m equal to 1, you will find tan inverse, first term will provide 3 minus tan inverse 1. And another term, what you will get? In the second term, you will get tan inverse. So that is m square plus m plus 1, 2 square 4 plus 2, 6 plus 1, 7. So tan inverse 7 minus tan inverse 3, and in this way another bracket, and another bracket, you see tan inverse, you will find 3 square plus 3 plus 1, so 9 plus 3 12 plus 1 13, so 13 and minus tan inverse 7, you can note down, right? And plus so on ... up to infinity you have to reach out, and solving, what you will find, here the result will be as it is tan inverse 7. So you see tan inverse 3 is retaliated to this. Tan inverse 7, you see it is retaliating like this way. right? So somehow tan inverse 13 is also retaliating with some terms, and so on. These terms retaliated. Finally, the result will be only the term left, that is tan inverse 1 in negative. And you see, when it reaches up to infinity, the result will be tan inverse pi by 2, means tan inverse infinity, that is pi by 2. So here the final answer is pi by 2 corresponding to this infinity, and corresponding to this tan inverse 1, that is 1. Or you better just you write down right over here like this. Let me write over here. That is tan inverse infinity minus tan inverse 1 to avoid the confusion. So tan inverse infinity, that is pi by 2, and tan inverse in this way, the result is pi by 4. Usually such type of problems you will find that usually the answer is pi by 4, but not always try to do this. About tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, tan inverse x minus y. So let me recall what we have studied. So first we have studied this formula, tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. There are the three conditions: xy less than 1 and xy, this one, greater than 1. So for xy greater than 1, there are the two conditions: when x and y both of them are negative, then you have to use minus pi. Similarly, here one more formula we have studied, tan inverse x minus tan inverse y, that is tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy, xy is minus 1, and so for this. When xy is greater than minus 1, that is tan inverse x minus y upon 1 plus xy, when x is positive, y is negative, xy is less than minus 1, that it means xy less than minus 1, then you have to use pi plus this, and xy less than minus 1 when x is positive and y is negative. Here x is y is positive, positive and y is negative, then you have to use plus pi. In the next turn, minus sin inverse y, cos inverse x plus cos inverse y, cos inverse x minus cos inverse y for detail, and we will prove this also, and we will use in different formulas and problems. So we will go for more and more formula to just learn more about inverse trigonometric function. And inverse trigonometric function, once again I will request you to just learn on your fingertips about domain, range, and graphs of all six inverse trigonometric function. Three of them are always increasing type of inverse trigonometric function. So that's all, and you just make a more practice on this inverse trigonometric function. Conditions are there. Okay, thank you.